There are hundreds of Muslim scientists through the ages, each more impactful than another in many different disciplines. Some of them are more famous or recognized than others. Some won prizes and medals, while others are only known for their ideas and attempts. In this episode, we will cover some scientists from the past and recent times that are perhaps less famous but probably as important as any others because they have shaped the world we live in. Hey, do you want to see a film and TV streaming service amplifying Muslim stories and filmmakers? If so, you want to check out our sponsor, Ozhub TV. Check the link in the description to find out more. Have you heard of Ibn Al-Haytham, the inventor of the first camera? Ibn Al-Haytham, born in Basra, laid the foundations for optical devices like cameras. The word camera itself comes from the Arabic qumra, small dark room with only one tiny window. He wrote the Book of Optics, disproving the Greek theories of how the eye see. The Greeks said that sight occurred because of rays emanating from the eye itself. However, he rejected this and through a series of experiments showed that light traveled in straight lines and that we can see due to light reaching the eye from a source. He proved his theory through experimentation using dark chambers. This was unusual for this time as physics had been more like philosophy without experimentation. Ibn al-Haytham also studied lenses, experimenting with different mirrors, flat, spherical, parabolic, cylindrical, concave and convex. He treated the eye as a dioptric system by applying the geometry of refraction to it. Fatima al-Firhi, the founder of the first university. Fatima al-Firhi, a merchant's daughter, established in the year 859 the Karawiyin Mosque, the first university in the world in Fez in Morocco. Fatima was born around 800 AD in the town of Kairouan in present-day Tunisia. Her family was part of a large migration to Fez from Kairouan. She and her sister Mariam were well educated and studied the Islamic jurisprudence and the Hadith. Although her family did not start out wealthy, her father, Muhammad al-Firhi, became a successful merchant. When he died, his wealth was inherited by Fatima and her sister Mariam. Al-Firhi was married, but both her husband and father died shortly after the wedding. Fatima used the money inherited from her father to build Al-Karawiyin Mosque, named after the immigrants from her hometown of Kairouan. The construction project was supervised by Fatima herself. The mosque took 18 years to build. Although it started out as mosque, it will soon become a place for the study of various disciplines. Abbas ibn Firnas, who performed the very first flight. Abbas ibn Firnas was an Andalusi inventor, astronomer, physician, chemist, engineer, musician, and Arabic language poet. He devised a means of manufacturing colorless glass, invented various glass planispheres, made corrective lenses, simulated the motion of the planets and the stars. One day, he covered himself with feathers, attached to a couple of wings to his body, and getting on a height, flung himself down into the air, but hurt his back during the landing. The Baghdad International Airport has a statue of him, and a crater on the moon has been named after him. Al-Idrisi, the first world map. Abu Abdullah Muhammad Al-Idrisi, born in Ceuta in Spain, was a geographer, cartographer, and Egyptologist who, for some time, lived in Palermo in Sicily. He created the Tabula Rogeriana, one of the most advanced medieval world maps. The Tabula Rogeriana was drawn for the Norman King Roger II of Sicily. It took 15 years to complete. The map with legends written in Arabic, while showing the Eurasian continent in its entirety, only shows the northern part of the African continent and lacks details of the Horn of Africa and Southeast Asia. For Roger, it was inscribed on a massive disc of solid silver, 2 meters in diameter and weighing about 300 pounds. The map presented the world as a sphere. Al-Idrisi calculated the circumference of the Earth within 10% of its accurate actual value. His descriptions of many parts of the Earth are still valid and were almost as accurate as modern maps. For 3 centuries, geographers copied his maps without alteration. The Banu Musa brothers. The invention of the first automatic and programmable machine. The brothers Jafar, Ahmed and Al-Hassan ibn Musa ibn Shakir were born around 800 in Baghdad. The Banu Musa brothers were engineers and among the first group of mathematicians to begin carry forward the mathematical developments begun by the ancient Greeks. Their book of ingenious devices, published in 850, was a large illustrated work on mechanical devices that included automatic devices. They devised an automatic flute player, which is considered as the first working example of a programmable machine. Steam was used to create the flute sounds, which could be adjusted by the user to enable different tunes. The brothers went on to develop a host of ingenious devices, including mechanical grabbers, lamps and fountains. Among special mentions, we found Hulusi Behçet, a dermatologist from Turkey who discovered a previously unknown disease of inflamed blood vessels, now known as the Behçet disease. Farouk Albaz, an Egyptian geologist who participated in the Apollo program. Mohammed Abdus Salam from Pakistan, who won the 1979 Nobel Prize in Physics. Ahmed Zewail, an Egyptian-American professor who won the Nobel Prize in 1999 for his analysis of chemical reactions. Aziz Sancar is a Turkish molecular biologist who in 2015 was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for his studies of DNA repair. Maryam Mirzakhani, who died in 2017, was the first woman being awarded a Fields Medal, the equivalent of a Nobel Prize for Mathematics, for her analysis of complex surfaces. Finally, we have Dr. Ugur Shaheen and Dr. Ozlem Turci, the couple who founded BioNTech, which gave the world one of the first vaccines against COVID-19. While the world has more and more Muslim scientists, why is it more difficult to see Muslim scientists achieving things that could completely change the world? First, the major foundations of modern science have already been uncovered. There is simply less room for individual big discoveries. Second, progress in science needs larger teams, more resources and more time. It is more difficult to make a big impact unless you have a huge amount of resources. Scientific progress is now in the hands of the wealthiest. Third, as a consequence, people who shape the world are more businessmen and politicians. The question is, at what cost? 4. People will realize that the biggest challenges are not only technological, but human and social. To control the excesses of artificial intelligence or human augmentations, one needs philosophers and anthropologists. To ensure that people who live on Mars make a good society, one needs sociologists and psychologists. To create better systems of governance, one needs political scientists and historians. The biggest unknown is not the infinity of the universe or the origin of life, but to understand the human being and how to create a harmonious society where no one is oppressed or deprived, which we haven't solved yet. When you subscribe to our channel, it helps us demonstrate we've got an audience, so we can apply for resources to create more and better quality content. Thanks for helping us.